All right, welcome back everyone. I'm with my sweetheart today. Christmas, as we know, less than a week away. One of the most delicious traditions, of course, is eggnog. I'm crazy for eggnog.
I love eggnog.
And our vegan Vicki, Sonia Steele, is here with her dairy-free eggnog recipe.
Yes.
How can that be?
You know, it can be.
Really?
Yes, it can
be. But with
people.
You, I know anything's possible.
Anything is possible. So this is actually a recipe that I came up with myself because a lot of the dairy-free, a lot of the, you know, vegan eggnogs, they actually have nuts in them.
I was gonna say usually made from like almond
milk
and
cashews and things like that.
Sorry.
But again, like I told them before, my nut allergy. So I had to come up with a recipe that is easy for people that, you know, have dairy, you know, intolerance or any type of, don't want to have all of that heaviness of the eggnog.
True.
So we're just
heaviness is so fattening.
I know it is, but this is actually low in fat.
Oh, I love you.
And full of flavor.
Okay, good.
So we're just gonna start by adding all of the ingredients to the blender. This is just a unsweetened soy milk.
Okay.
And Sam Silk. Look, I'm using silk milk.
I like silk
but
milk.
But it's not his, but it's just,
okay.
It was funny to me when
in
my head.
Because that was our guest previous, just so you know,
so,
if you're just tuning in, that's why. That was funny, that was good,
I like that. Thank you,
okay, now
but to make it creamy, we're using a full fat coconut milk.
Oh.
Okay, and people may get mixed up by the full fat, it's just the regular coconut milk,
nothing,
you know, so we're gonna add
that.
And
I actually, that's okay.
It matches my sweater.
Okay, good.
Okay. So we've got, and you're gonna put it in the refrigerator so it will get creamy.
Like that?
Yes.
Or we wait? Okay.
No, like that. And then we have frozen bananas.
Okay.
That is gonna actually add to the creaminess of it. We have maple syrup.
Maple syrup.
Yes. You're gonna use a half a cup, but the recipe is on the website.
Okay.
And we're having nutmeg and cinnamon.
That smells
Doesn't it smell good?
Awesome? That is like the holidays,
and we're
right?
Adding vanilla extract.
Okay.
And believe it or not, that's the whole recipe.
That's it.
That's it. And then you're just adding all of that to the blender.
Okay.
And we're just gonna just tut it on.
Fire it
blend
up.
Blend it up. Boom. And that's it.
That's it.
That's it. And then what you wanna do is you actually want to chill. Put this in a container, put it in the freezer, and maybe chill it for about 2 hours or the refrigerator just a little longer to get it chilled and to thicken up. And guess what?
What?
I have some for everybody.
You do?
What
of course you do.
I know, right?
Yeah, you would.
So we have,
here,
I'm gonna get you guys some cups.
Let me ask you this.
Yes.
Are those vegan cookies?
Yes, they are.
Yeah.
Glad that you asked, Wayne.
Thank you. So what you can do, this is such an easy recipe. When you are wrapping gifts,
there you go, Wayne.
If you're, you know, opening gifts with your family, you can actually have some delicious cookies.
Mm.
How you like it?
I love it.
Yeah, and you know,
I love
it's full of flavor, but it's half the fat,
and
half
can,
the calories.
And you can taste a little bit of that banana, but
like
not too much, but
like
a little bit.
That's why a lot of people don't do eggnog,
because
it's so rich.
Because it's so rich.
It's like skim milk in it.
Exactly.
Yeah,
a lot of people do that, but this, you have the creaminess from the banana, from the coconut milk.
Cheers.
And cheers.
Cheers.
This is very good.
And also, we have some Swedish meatballs. You can add a savory or sweet taste to this.
Mm-hmm.
So we have vegan snickerdoodle cookies.
Ooh, yum.
And we have
the fudgy.
I'll try one of those.
Yes.
Look
and
at the fudgy.
I'm gonna fudge
crinkle cookies.
Oh.
And you can have that with this or, this is, turn the kids away. You can add a little
Bailey's,
little something with this.
I'm just saying.
Right. You can add a little something with it for the people.
Just to warm you up.
Yeah. And you can actually heat this up too, where you can have a hot eggnog.
Can I tell you?
Yes.
That's really good.
I never thought of that.
I need to sell that. You hear that, people? Hit me up. Call me. Website, I'm just saying.
She's the best.
Listen.
She is the best. And these cookies are to die
for.
Oh my gosh,
they're so good.
So
are
easy.
These,
to
are
die
these
for.
Fewer calories in this too?
Yes. Those are fewer calories because you're not using the egg, you're not using the whole milk or butter.
You have to come back and make these cookies.
I'm telling you.
Yes.
Right?
You're not missing anything
if you make me a batch of
these. You need a fudgy one too.
I got you.
This is fantastic.
Yes.
You can
find
her info on our website, fox8.com.
With my family.
Vicki, Merry Christmas.
Merry Christmas, everybody.
Thank you.
Yes. All right, so coming up next on Fox 8 News, we are talking family leave in today's download. Mm-hmm. The Cleveland Clinic has actually updated their family leave policy to give more time off to employees, so should other companies start following suit? Stacey's reading your comments next. Also coming up, one family has a wildlife habitat in their Christmas tree. How they discovered this owl in their tree after a week of putting it up. Check it out. It just took up residency. More when we come back. Stay close.
Fox 8 Recipe Box is brought to you by Dean Supply.